Hello! In this video, we'll be covering the reliability of random forests. We said before that a decision tree may not produce the optimal tree since it uses a greedy algorithm to build it. However, there is a sense of reliability that comes from the capacity of random forests to find the optimal tree. This is done by randomizing the datasets that creates each tree where there is no overlap in data. Then, a data point is pushed through each tree, where the result is the average of the results of each tree. So let's examine what that would look like. Here we have a dataset consisting of four colors: red, blue, green, and yellow. Instead of creating one decision tree for this data, we'll split up the dataset. This split would be random, but for the sake of easy visualization, the splits here have been made evenly. The dataset has been split into four subsets. As such, four decision trees can be built in parallel. Since these trees are being built at the same time, it decreases the runtime to build the trees, since we're building four small trees rather than one large tree. Next, we'll insert a data point into each tree. The point will traverse through the tree until it reaches the leaf node. Looking at where each point is located in their respective trees, think about what color each one should be based on the other colors in that node. Let's take a look at the histogram or class prediction of what each point would be. So based on all of these histograms, we need to average them to get the real classification of the unknown data point. This histogram is the average of the results of the four trees. As you might expect, this simply means that we took the results of each color, added them together, and divided by the number of trees. So this is what the unknown data point can equal. We see that the average presents a highest chance of being yellow, with green being a close second. Clearly, there's also a very low chance of the point being red or blue. There are two sources of randomness in random forests. First, there is randomness in the data due to bootstrapping, and second, there is randomness in the split of the features. Randomness is important in random forests because it allows us to have distinct, different trees that are based off of different data. This is important because if we push a data point through each tree, and they all produce the same result, then most likely that data point can be classified as that result. None of the trees have any association with any other tree due to the uniqueness. Decision trees that are very deep tend to overfit the data, where they have low bias and high variance. When we have each tree based on different subsets of the data, each tree ends up having a lot higher variance. By averaging these trees, we're able to reduce the overall variance, although there's still a small increase in bias. Another reason why bootstrapping is good is that we're able to better the model's performance by preserving the bias while decreasing the variance. Thanks for watching.